the early 1970s in Austin, Texas, a young guitarist began to make his name on the local blues circuit, tirelessly committed to a musical form many thought outdated. 10 years later, that same guitarist became an international phenomenon. A player of passion, energy, and awe-inspiring technical virtuosity, Stevie Ray Vaughan not only brought the blues heritage of his home state to a global audience, but also reinvigorated the genre itself and introduced it to a new generation of listeners.
Stevie just seemed to live and breathe music every single minute. It was just his whole life.
This was a burning fire that didn't have anything to do with what people thought. You witnessed some of his live gigs where you would think, you know, he's going to just break the guitar in half with his hands. It's genuine. It was sweet. It's not the kind of intensity thing. Oh, why does he have to act like that, you know? Only he could come up with that type of emotion without it being an act.
This film not only looks at the formative years of Vaughan's career, his influences, his first recordings, and the various bands in which he honed his craft, but also traces the history of Texas blues itself and identifies Vaughan's place within a larger tradition. It is the journey of both a musical form and the single-minded musician who brought it back into the spotlight.
His guitar playing just jumps right off the record. It just grabs a hold of you, and it's just undeniable.
What he did with the sound was totally unique, and nobody has come close. Stevie just did it because he had his own ideas and he was committed to his music. And if he ended up just playing clubs all the rest of his life rather than sacrificing who he was musically, he probably would have chosen playing clubs the rest of his life. He knew what he wanted to do.
Stevie brought respect back to blues. He brought recognition back to blues. But by making it a completely unique, original, and modern sound again. This guy was really a master artist.
When Stevie Ray Vaughan broke into the mainstream in the early 1980s, he cut a distinctive and contradictory figure. Seemingly archaic and out of date, yet also explosive and refreshingly different. He was a standard bearer for a form of music that had been dismissed as unfashionable and unmarketable for over a decade, the blues, and his global success revitalized the genre.
Blues has always had ups and downs, but it had been down for a long, long time. Record deals were very few and far between. Just being taken seriously was not happening. So for Stevie to make such an impact worldwide, change that. All of a sudden people were starting to pay attention, and it really helped everyone from the ground up. Nobody else is making this music by this stage, or nobody is making it and selling it in any sizable quantities. He refreshes the blues. He makes the blues hip again. So hugely significant, both in terms of its influence on white rock and roll, but also in what it does to black music. Johnny Hooker in the 1980s and early 1990s sells more records in that sort of decade that he sold in 40 years up until that point. And Stevie Ray Vaughan has one hell of a lot to do with that. Stevie Ray Vaughan, almost single-handedly, you know, there are other people, there's George Thorogood, there's Robert Cray, but Stevie Ray Vaughan is the superstar. He's the man who puts blues back on the map and makes people want to listen to the blues again and realise that there's something worth hearing.